I had met T.I. was one of the first rappers I had ever called to ask me to like freestyle on a mixtape. Like literally the first phone call I ever got was from Jason Jeter about a rapper coming to rock with me. The irony of it now, just thinking about how many calls I get, and that was the first one that somebody did that. And we had started a working relationship. So I was, you know, working with Grand Hustle and Tip at the time, and this is like around when he had left his first record deal and 24s was heating up in the streets, and they had their mixtape series, so they were familiar with what I was doing. And then, you know, I also had a vision and understood, like, all right, here's an artist that, you know, I see a lot of potential in, you know, is big in his own right. I'm coming up, he's coming up. Like, if I attach myself to him, you know, I can kind of create, you know. When it comes to hip hop, I, you know, there's Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince, there's Eric B and Rakim, there's Who Kid and 50. Like, I was looking at all those blueprints, and I knew that Tip could be that guy for me. So the idea, Jason Jeter actually had the idea initially to do a Gangsta Grillz where it'd be all literally one artist, and, you know, and the crew. So it was like all T.I. and Grand Hustle Gangsta Grillz. So that really was the changing point for when Gangsta Grillz went from like a compilation of the hottest songs to the only place you could get this music on. And the first Gangsta Grillz of its kind at the time was the T.I. and PSC Meets in the Streets. So that took off like hotcakes, you know, that at the time it being my biggest tape, and like, you know, Tip was on fire, the brand was coming up, and, you know, it became an in-demand thing.